Hey guys, Plasticity 1.2 just launched a few days ago and it's just completely blowing my mind and I want to show you some crazy features. Yes, so before we start, check out here Glenn Patterson. So he has some really cool videos about the new functions in Plasticity 1.2 and I just want to show you my favorite ones. So first of all, here this is a little concept I've been working on. So now if you pick a point here on the cursor and you rotate only around that. So now, for example, the lip, and you see you rotate around the lip and not anymore in the middle of this whole world. And some people like it, some not. And if you don't like it, just go here to the preferences. And here you have some navigation settings and you can play around with them. But now it's absolutely perfect. All right. So let's first start with bridge curve command. And this is so cool. So first of all, you have here just a basic cylinder and we will just copy it and just bring it to some random other position and we will just rotate it. So before that, if you wanted to connect it in a nice aesthetic way, you had to do so much of pivoting around and adjusting the points. But now you just have here bridge curves and you can go here to the center and here to the center and bam, you have an absolute perfect curve and you can even adjust it here with the tension or just press D and play around. And how this could be or is crazy useful. So if we delete all that, so I have here a pipe right in the neck and I just love that kind of stuff. And man, that was a hassle to create this curve and all that stuff. But now again, go here to your bridge curve, snap it here, for example, and also here at the bottom and bam, it's perfect. Now you can just press P and just create your pipe and you have a perfectly aligned pipe and that's just amazing. Or a tip from Pixel Fondue. So what you could do, so your pipe is created and a way to create a corrugated tube is if you go here to the top view and create a sphere and go here to the middle center and drag it around and press B. Okay, it's not in the center, but anyway, to create a sphere. And now if you press Alt Z, so you're in X-ray mode and it's a little bit confusing, but if you select the sphere and press S and press V to pivot here to the middle, so it's following this pipe and you scale it just a little bit flatter and Alt Z to go out of the X-ray. And now you can select this body, press F and curve array and array it here along that curve. And you see already what's happening. And yeah, here it has to be a little bit adjusted, but yeah, I'm just showing you here some techniques and you can create this kind of curve. So press OK, press Q and Q again to Boolean that, press OK. And let's have a look. And yeah, that just looks so, so cool and amazing. So now you can extend curves along the curvature. For example, I want to create here some detail, but you see we have this curve here, but then it's breaking here. But maybe I want to extend it just to create some details. I don't know. We have to figure that out, how we can implement it in our workflow. But for example, select this curve here or both of them, Shift D. So you have it separate and press J. So we just have one curve. And now you can select, for example, just this point here. So go up to one in points mode and press F and extend curve. And then you see it doesn't work. And if it doesn't work, go back, select this curve here again and just rebuild it. And then it should work. So you see it's still everything the same. But now again, go to this endpoint, press F and extend curve. And now you can drag it out and see it just follows this curvature along. So let's do also the same for this endpoint. So again, select it, F, and again, select this point here, F, extend curve, and let's extend it. And you have here some other shapes, but yeah, this natural one looks the best in my opinion. So now you see you have a cool curvature, which is following this curvature that it had. I don't know. And now, for example, you can just press P and give it a little bit of a pipe or something. And now just let's select this pipe and just bring it a little bit outwards. And now you can select here this breast piece or chest piece and this here and boolean that. And we have a cool, really nice aesthetic little detail. So let me show you here. So yeah, you see, you could just paint a little bit around, make some patterns and all that stuff. So this is really, really cool. Again, we have to figure out how we can use it in our workflow. So let's go to the next cool feature. So yeah, this is also a grenade from my new plasticity, sci-fi and product design course. Check it out, first link in the description. But for example, you can now just select any add. Let's take this one and this one. And now you can just bridge them by selecting them and just F for searching the commands and bridge edge, and bam, you see they're instantly like bridged. And you have here on the bottom left a lot of commands. So press D, for example, to adjust the tension. And I don't know, maybe you want to create some kind of an arc, or maybe you want to bring it here to the bottom. So then you have here some side controls. So yeah, this looks crazy, but just untick them both. And then it's just here at the bottom. So really cool. And you can also play here with the tangent, with the tangent or curvature values. So yeah, right click and you have then here this extra edge. So really cool. New feature that I finally love so much. So for example, now if you just create a rectangle, press C, something like that. So now if you bevel it, you can fill it and chamfer that. And man, this is so cool because you don't have to cut anymore so much to create a chamfer. So let me just show you something. So if you go here to the front view, so if we create some really cool, I don't know, just a random sci-fi shape here. So something like that. And we just bring this point here. And now, for example, if we wanted before that to create here a chamfer, because maybe it's a little bit too sharp, we had to create here a new curve and trim that away, and this was too crazy. So now just select this point here and you can just give it here a nice little chamfer. Yeah, to break a little bit here the sharpness, or the same here. Just chamfer or fill it as you want, but chamfer. And definitely also here, give it a nice, cool little chamfer, and you see, you have a really cool shape, and yeah, you can extrude it and then play a little bit around with that. So yeah, just a little thing. So now let's come to the really interesting new features. You can bridge surfaces. This is already crazy. So let me just show you. Create Shift F, just here, a random curve. So something like that, select this curve, press E to extrude it. So we have something like that, select the surface, Shift D to duplicate it. And let's just rotate it, and G, just bring it here and just rotate it just this way. And let's just extrude those here a little bit. So yeah, we have something like that. So if you press F and bridge surfaces, select this face and this face, and you see now you can just bridge them. And you also have here some, so you can adjust the width, how smooth you want to have it. And also here you have sensors, so you can connect or select the different intersections. So you remember, you can select this one here, so it's connecting, or this on the left. So again, bridge surface, this face and this face, and just play around here with the sensors. And also you can even give it the chamfer. And yeah, again, we have to figure out how we can implement it, but let me show you something. For example, if you just take this surface and Shift D, and let's just bring it out, and again Shift D, and I don't know, let's just randomly rotate it a little bit and just, I don't know, bring it here. And now let's just try to connect them. So F, bridge surface, and select this one and this one, and bam, and you see here, you can just create really crazy stuff. Like, look at this. And I can imagine you can create so cool, organic, cool little shapes. Like, look at this. It could be, I don't know, like some armor plate or something, you know? And yeah, so we just have to play around and see how we can implement this. All right, so let's check out something new about the curves before we come to lofting and patching what completely will blow your mind. So let's have a look here. So this drone again from my new sci-fi and product design course. So check it out. For example, we have here some cage curves, which we built that around, and we have a lot of curves as you see. But now what we can do, we can just adjust colors to our curves. So for example, we have here this, so we have this cage curves that we built that main shape. So if we select all of them, for example, and we just press M for material, so it's the same as you would give a color to a surface or body, and just go to color and let's make that here something like that, right click. And you see, now we can differentiate all of those curves. So I think this is really handy. Or for example, we selected that curves to create here those design cuts. Again, press M and maybe those one we gives a red one. So now it just makes a little bit more sense if we have too much curves ongoing. But yeah, always good to put them all into separate groups. So also what we can do now we can trim curves. So before it was only possible. So if we have something like that on a planar surface, we could only trim with T this here when it's planar on a face, right? So now it's everything planar. So, but now it's possible to trim curves with 3D, and this is just so cool. So let me just pick this surface here and shift D to duplicate it and shift H. So now you see it's a 3D surface. So now let's do something interesting. Just create here a line and we will just rectangular array it with a few more times. So we have something like that. And let's create also one line this way. And again, rectangular array and just a few more. So we have something like that. Alt click to all of those curves, bring them to the front and just F for imprint curve command, really cool, to this body here. So right click. And now we can just select all of those with alt click and delete. And now, I don't know, we have a kind of polygons here. So edge mode, select all of them and shift D. So now we have all of those curves extra, and let's delete the surface. So now you see, I don't know, it's so cool. We built kind of a wireframe. I don't know. We have to figure out what we can do with that. But now if we press T, so we are in the trim command. Yeah. Do whatever you want. So you can just here trim everything around, even if it's a curved surface. So really, really cool. And I think that will give us a lot of interesting possibilities. But now, let's check out lofting and surfacing. And when I saw that, it's just what the hell is happening here. So let's create a new file. So the other day I was here practicing this shape here, and before 1.2, that was pretty advanced. but now let's just recreate the shape here. Very simple to show you just a few new features. And yeah, this is absolutely crazy. So let's go to plasticity. And yeah, if you want to learn how to create this kind of shapes, I will do a lot of tutorials on that. So subscribe so you don't miss them. So let's build it like very, very simple. Let's go to the top view, create the circle, shift D, just bring it here. It doesn't have to be in the middle and stuff. And shift A and snap it to the tangent and tangents of the circles. Press T to trim that around. So now let's select all of those curves with alt click J and E to extrude them. And what I don't like, so alt click with face and just make them a little bit, something like that. And yeah, just drag that a little bit more outwards. Perfect. And now let's go here to the right view and create a circle which is a little bit bigger. So as in the example, but of course it's not exactly now. Let's make it maybe a little bit bigger and shift D to bring it here. And now just select this circle and this circle, press L to loft it. Let's delete that. And now let's cut them in half. I will show you how to connect that. So create a line C, cut this body here, And the same for this body. So select that C and just delete that. So perfect. We have something like that. Yeah, before that. So now, so if we take our reference, we have to connect and everything in a smooth way. And now you can do this with beautiful lofts and patching. So for example, let's create me here a line and cut this body. We don't need this top piece. And now, so if you select this face here, Control R, and we can give here an edge and the same here. And also let's snap one line here to the middle and select that face and delete it. So now you see we have to connect very smoothly this thing here. And how it's possible now, it's just so easy and so beautiful. And yeah, it will just blow your mind. So it's a little bit advanced, but so yeah, oh, my light is turned off. But yeah, we have this shape here, and let's connect this top piece with this bottom piece. And there are 1 million different ways how we could do this, but let me just show you the new patch tool. So let's first of all select this face and Control R, just give it an extra edge here, and the same here. So something like that. So now we can connect this right piece, the middle piece, and the left piece. And now we can just use our bridge edge command. So F and bridge edge. So you see we get this really smooth line, and the same let's do here. F bridge edge, and let's do here. And let's do also here. Perfect. So now you see we have this kind of smooth cage, and now this new patch function is so amazing. So now we can just select any edges, so they don't have to be connected, they don't have to be on one surface or one body. We can just draw what we need, and basically I can see already that surface and you just select it and you just click here patch, and bam, you have it. But if you right click and you go here to this shading mode, you see it's not smooth, so we don't have continuity, because you have to go back, and when you patch it, you have here G0, and you can just press tab, then you go everywhere to G1, or you can adjust it here manually with the continuity that you want. So if it's G1, this is the most important here, then all of those surfaces will blend in smoothly and they will follow the curvature of the main surface. So that one and that one. So right click. So if everything is G1 and we press OK, you see it looks so, so smooth and so, so beautiful. So let's do here the same. So we select all of those edges, patch holds, press tab. So everything is G1 and OK, and it's beautiful. And we can do the same here. And I had a few extra sheets here, I don't know why, so just delete them. So again, select those curves here, patch holes, press tab. So you see G1 everywhere. So it should be looking everything very smooth. And it is, it's not perfect, but yeah, you have to basically, you have to adjust it a little bit. And, but yeah, that was really cool. But let's try something. So if we go back, and we have that. So let's go back till we are here and just see if we can bridge those surfaces. I don't know, maybe it's possible. So let's select those three lines here and just bring them up. And yeah, so we don't have even to loft or patch anything. So let's press F and bridge surface. And let's just select this one and this one. It's just possible. What the fuck? And we can just bridge that? How is that possible? So let me 600. Okay, that's too much. But 400. Okay, it didn't work that way. So again, let's bridge that. And we can just bridge that. This is crazy. And even with the chamfer, but this enables to create such an interesting shape so easy. So this is really, really cool. And yeah, let's go one step further. Let's select those and bring them to the other side and press G. So now let's try again. F and bridge surface. And okay, yeah, this is not working. So if you do this kind of stuff, it's always good if you just break it in half. But yeah, we have to experiment with that a little bit. But the new lofting and patch tool are just amazing. So yeah, that was just my little two cents for you. And if you're interested, check out my new flagship sci-fi and product design course where we create all of those models here. First link in the description. Here a sci-fi prop, a sci-fi grenade. Look all of the details and the design language and also that drone and also that camera all in just one course. Check out first link in the description. You have here some more information. Yeah, so I'm super excited about this new plasticity version. I will create a lot of tutorials on that and experiment and play around and figure out 1.2 with you together. And so I think plasticity's future is really, really bright. So let's explore it together. See you in my next tutorials. Check out the course. Bye.